Hi everyone, thanks for tuning in to Plastic EP's Brain Teasers. I'm Ashton Elizabeth. Are you ready to play the greatest quiz show with Plastic EP and Nathan Lou, Mr. Shampoo? Get ready, groovers. Let's go with the show.
Hey, one of the grooviest intros you can have. And I've got Charlie DeCosta. How are you, Charlie?
I'm doing good, Plastic. How are you?
I notice your hair's grown. You look better with a wig.
Oh, wig? What are you talking about, wig? This is mine. I bought
it. Did you like last week's show?
You know, I thought it was great fun. I thought it was
now, listen,
excellent.
I need you
fun.
To
what
play.
What did you think of last week's show?
Yeah, I like it. This show's going to be a gas now. We've got four people. We've got people playing now four games. And the thing is, we want you to stay on each show now to make sure I don't make a mistake, because I love adjudicating. And just to have you on the side, that would be great. Now,
well,
listen.
We've got to make sure it goes right. I mean, that's.
Yeah, because, you know, we don't cheat on this show.
Yep.
We don't cheat. All right, listen.
It's the only way I can win.
Let's start with love grows where my rosemary goes. Oh, let's start with that.
You know the words? I don't know the words.
Yeah, I do. Don't worry. No problem here.
What is it?
She acts kind of funny.
Kind of funny. Clothes are kind of funny. The hair is in a mystery.
Because grows
where my rosemary goes. And nobody knows like me. She ain't gonna leave me crying in a mystery. Because love grows where my rosemary goes. And nobody knows like me.
Bridge!
Something about that.
Of a kind, and a beautiful kind. And I just gotta say, hey, she's really got a magical spell, and it's working so well. And I just gotta say, kind of funny.
All right, that's all I know.
That's a beauty. That one, what about a bit of sugar, sugar?
You asked me for that one. Let's see. You are my candy girl, and you got me wanting you.
Come on, sing the other part. I just can't believe you're the love of my life. Listen, I gotta mention there's a big event happening right on October the 9th, Friday 2020. We've got Remembering Lennon, Imagine 80, October the 9th, a worldwide stream concert, event celebrating John's 80th birthday. Not to be missed. It's a virtual concert. They got one of the best John Lennon impersonators on there.
There's more on it
at the web. Make sure you get your tickets. That's going to be a great event there, Charlie.
Is that Charles Resonance?
Yeah, that's right.
I saw him on the horror show interview that you did.
How was that?
That was great. He was talking about some of the Dracula tours. And, you know, I don't know if you know who Gilbert Gottfried is. Do you know who Gilbert Gottfried is? He's a comedian here in the United States, and he loves all that horror stuff. And I'm wondering if he might have been on one of those tours.
Probably. It sounds really nice. Cool. I don't know. But as I said, everyone's into different things.
Yep.
And look, I'm coming in. We're in circles here like Time Tunnel. Isn't that amazing?
It looks like the Green Hornet.
Exactly. I look a bit like that. But as I said, don't forget to check that out and make sure you go to that virtual thing happening Friday, October the 9th. Remember, Lennon, Imagine 80. That's going to be fantastic.
Yeah, we're going to check it out. We're definitely going to check it out. It sounds cool. Do you know who
the... Charles, let's do another song before Mr. Shampoo comes on.
Oh, what should we do for Mr.... Oh, you know what? What he did recently, he did... what would you think if I sang out of tune? Would you stand up and walk out on me? He was playing bass.
Lend me your ears and I'll sing your song. Can I try to sing out of key?
I get
a little help from my friends.
Screwed that up.
That's okay. Listen, let's move on to an early Beatles song.
What do you got?
Let's go for Do You Want to Know a Secret? You'll never know how much I really love you. You'll never know how much I really care.
Listen.
Do you want to know a secret?
Do you promise not to tell?
Closer.
Let me whisper in your ear. Say the words you want to hear.
I'm in love with you.
Do you want to know the secret?
Do you promise not to tell?
Closer. Let me whisper in your ear.
I'm in love with you.
I've known a secret for a week or two. Nobody knows, just we two.
La 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 la.
There you go. Fantastic. Really tune this thing. So tell us what's going on in Australia there, in Melbourne, Australia.
We're down in curfew, but as I said, I don't want to get too much in there into that. But you got a few events happening. What do you got happening? Tell me.
Well, this coming Saturday, it's now Sunday, right? So this coming Saturday, we've got a show, an actual real-life show at the Tin Roof in Orlando. That's under the big Orlando Eye on International Drive. We're going to do our unplugged show, kind of like what we do with the Facebook Live shows. We're going to do that during the lunchtime. So it's kind of like a Beatle lunch, Beatle brunch kind of thing. And then the following Friday night, so the 25th, we're going to do a Facebook Live show with Beatle Beat. And you can go to the Beatle Beat tribute page. That's our group. And it'll be right on there. You could go watch. It's absolutely free. We're not doing the costumes or anything like that because we know that other bands are doing their costume show and charging for it and trying to make money off of that. So we don't want to interfere with what they do. We love all the guys out there doing it, and we're fans of some of the bands out there doing it. So, but we do our unplugged show. We just get together and play the music and really been having a good time with it.
That's great. You want to make them happy? I just want to say you got a message from Liverpool. Just shake your head a bit. Paul Dina said you're a star. Chiefs from Liverpool. How's that?
Well, thank you so much.
Listen, do you know one of my favorite bands?
Why do I look more like Austin Powers? Yeah, baby.
You know the Swinging Blue Jeans? I interviewed Ray Innes. He's a star.
I saw that interview. That was a good interview.
Yeah, I love the guy.
That he said that they hosted an open mic at the Cavern, and that's the first time the Beatles played the Cavern was with those guys. That's unbelievable. It's great stuff.
And he's 80 years old now. He's great.
He looked and sounded great.
Do you know that song, Hippie Hippie Shake?
Let's see.
I got the hippie hippie shake. Yeah.
Oh,
I got the hippie.
Yeah. For goodness sake. I got the hippie hippie shake. Oh, I got the shakes.
I can't sit still.
When I say I know it, I mean I've heard it.
I get my fill now. Very hippie, hippie shake. Oh, it's in the back. Yeah, the hippie shake.
Come on, plastic, sing it.
Shake it to the left, to the right, to the hippie shake.
Hey, Mr. Lou, Mr. How Shampoo, Nathan Lou.
Mr. Shampoo.
Hey, I was digging your bass playing on your video. Sounds great, man. Singing and bass playing.
Thank you very much, Charlie. That's very nice of you to say.
Oh, it's good stuff. Good stuff.
Hi, Plastic. And
you had your Magical Mystery Tour bass there, didn't you?
That Sergeant Pepper.
Your Rickenbacker bass.
That's right.
Yep.
Now listen, I got our first guest on here. One of our contestants is on. I'll say hello. Welcome, Fred. How are you?
Hi guys. Hi everybody.
Fred coming in from New York. He's a big Beatle fan like me too. He's got a book coming out on the monkeys soon, too.
Oh, yeah.
Well, tell us the name of the book, Fred.
I guess we're getting close to when hopefully we'll get the book out late October in time for Christmas sales. The book is going to be called, is a sequel to my first book, and it's going to be called A Little Bit Me, A Little Bit You, 2, The Monkeys from International Fans' Perspectives.
And guess what? I'm in the book about my poster being signed and taking 38 years to get signed by the Monkees. It's pretty good.
You're going to be in there, Plastic.
Can't ask for more than that. Now, listen, have you got a request for an early Beatles song, Fred?
Early Beatles. My favorite early Beatles song is I Should Have Known Better.
Well, there you go. Charlie's going to look better for you.
Talk for a minute, though. I got to tune this damn thing.
Good day, folks.
How are you, Mr. Shampoo? Ready to go?
I'm ready to go, Plastic. Who are you?
Tell us more about the book. I want to hear more about the Monkees book.
Well, the book is, like I said, it's a sequel to my first book, A Little Bit Me, A Little Bit You, The Monkees from a Fan's Perspective. This is my first book. And it's about my experiences with the Monkees as a fan, and it includes other fan stories in here. The new book is a sequel to this book, and it'll include fan stories from around the world. So we got Japan represented, England, Australia with Plastic up there. And of course,
cool.
some American fans. And plus as much as up to date on Monkey News as possible.
Very cool.
Including unfortunately the recent passing of Peter Tork.
Fred, where can they buy the first book from?
The first book is available through Amazon and Smashwords. If you want to get the Kindle, that's available on Amazon. And you get both the print book and the Kindle book on both on Amazon. So you have to go to Amazon, look up Fred Velez or my book, A Little Bit Me, A Little Bit You, The Monkees from a Fan's Perspective, and you can get it there.
Cool. Should have known better, right?
Yes.
Yeah.
All right, all you guys got to sing with me. You ready?
Right.
2, 3, 4.
I never realized what it used to be. This could only happen to me. Can't you see?
Can't you see?
That when I tell you that I love you.
All right. Good show,
very,
gentlemen.
Very good guitar for a bass player, Charlie.
Yeah. Thank you so much. Trying.
Hey, Nathan, do you like his wig? Looks great.
Wig? What are you talking about, wig?
Instant hair.
You talking about Mr. Shampoo? Mr. Shampoo, is he wearing a wig?
I'm talking to Charlie. That's no wig. Nathan, that's his real hair.
So I used to go see Davey every year at Epcot. He played at Epcot for years. Oh, wow. He did the concert series. I saw him there. I've seen Mickey a few times, and I saw the three. I saw Mickey, Peter, and Davey at a concert in North Carolina in 2001. It was excellent. Excellent. Cool. Peter stole the show because, he just went up to the keyboard, was playing. He was playing guitar. Really, really good stuff. Oh,
Peter was an excellent musician.
Of course,
he was the best one.
Well, let me ask you this.
Yes.
Let me ask you this. So after Peter died and they interviewed Mickey and Mike said that there was a lot of friction between him and Peter.
Yeah.
So without going into too much detail, was it a musical difference? Was it a personal difference? You know much about it?
The thing is they both came musically from two different areas. Mike more from country, western, rock. And Peter more from the folky scene in Greenwich Village.
Greenwich Village, so, yeah.
Yeah, there was that little bit there. It might have been a personal thing. I think Mike and Peter, this is just my opinion. And Mike, I think, clarified it a little bit. There was more of a working relationship between the two. Sure. So there's co-workers more than collaborative partners. Even though they have collaborated and they did some fantastic things together, all you got to do is listen to the entire Headquarters album. You see how all these guys meshed.
Oh, what a great album. Great album. What'd you think of Daydream Believers, the movie about the monkeys? Did you enjoy that one?
There were aspects of it that were true. It's just that they jumbled it all up.
Yeah.
You know? And I, like everybody else, I hate the ending.
Right.
The ending's not realistic. If it was me, if I had written the script, my ending would have been that they would go back to that diner and, they're saying, well, we got this TV special now. The movie flopped. And Peter says, I don't know how much longer I'm going to be with you guys. But maybe one day we'll get the respect we deserve. Then flash forward to the 1986 reunion at the point where Mike Nesmith joins them on stage at the Greek Theater and does listen to the band. And I think that would have been the perfect ending.
Yeah. Yeah, it was a little cheesy Disney-esque ending, but the guys they had playing them were fantastic.
They did a good job.
The actors were really good, I thought.
Mickey was very good.
I got to introduce your man, Ken Womack. He's got a brand new book.
Hey, guys. He's
got a brand new book about John Lennon coming out.
Hello.
How are you all doing?
Doing fine, thank you.
Charlie DeCosa, Mr. Shampoo, Nathan Liu, and Fred Velez. And you'll be playing against Fred. We're just waiting for the champ to come in, who is Ken Michaels. And then we'll be going for it.
All right.
We can't wait for your new book, Ken. Can you tell us a bit about the book?
Sure. It's called John Lennon 1980.
Oh, cool. And
it's a study of how...
What's it about?
Who's the subject?
Yeah, I don't know. It's such a cryptic title, right?
Oh, my goodness. Yes. You love cryptic titles.
Yeah, that's
right. Have you got the book there, Ken? You can show them the cover.
I probably do.
Can we see it for a minute?
Can we probably see it?
Might as well see it.
Your collection from afar.
He's got a lot of books there.
Oh, oh my goodness, that's nice.
Look at that. That's his new book. Ooh, what day is it coming out for sale?
It comes out in the U.S. on Tuesday and everywhere else on October 8th.
Oh, okay. Nice. Very nice.
Where can I get it from, Ken?
Well, maybe I should be sending you a copy since we've spent so much time together.
Well, I'm not going to say no if you sign it, you send it to me. But as I said, I'm not focusing on that, but that would be great if you do that. But tell me, everyone can buy the book because we want to get the sales up. It's a great book.
Well, thank you. And you look very good with that, your new body. Have you become like robotic or something?
Exactly. How'd you know?
Well, because you look like you're in the middle of like a green bullseye.
Yeah, time tunnel, but look at this. Ken's on, but look. My eyes should be green. Well, my head's going green.
That was cool, Charlie. What kind of guitar is that?
This is a cheapy Gretsch Electromatic. It's got just something to kick around the house with. But I was trying to play the Green Hornet stuff, but I'm no Al Hurt. It was Al Hurt, wasn't it?
Well, Al Hurt wasn't actually a guitarist.
Yeah, no, very much trumpet. So, Ken, where are you out of?
We're waiting for Ken now, but
I'm on the Jersey Shore.
I've got another contestant on waiting as well. So we've got everybody.
Jersey Shore. I played at the quarter deck on Long Beach Island, Jersey. You know where that is?
That's actually south of us. We're closer to the city.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
We're about 20 miles from New York.
I'm just saying, Michael, we're talking about monkeys. You're playing the second game, but it's good that you've come in early. We'll say hello to you while you're there.
Well, hey, hi. I didn't expect to be popped
up. Hey, Michael.
Hello, everyone.
Hey, Michael.
Tell us about your monkey book. You got a monkey book out. What is it?
I've got two monkey books out with Mark Arnold. One of them is all about the every single song they've ever recorded, and we go into each detail song and talk about it. And the other one is called Headquarters, which is about their solo years. You know, once they there it is, that one. Yes, that's about the. I got the other one. Oh well, should have had it ready. I'm sorry.
I like the book. I like the fact that you use my photo in it.
Okay, well, wait a minute. You go into every song, so I'm going to ask you a question out of the book here. Love, what was it? Love to me is blue, white, and blonde. What's the Magnolia Sims?
Right.
So at the end of Magnolia Sims, they have the record skip, and then it jumps back on. Tell me about that. You got any information on that?
No, not really. Only that, you know, Mike wanted to be clever. You know, it's his song. He wrote it. And there was a song about a year before that called Winchester Cathedral, if you remember that. Yeah. Right. So he was trying to do that sort of 1920s style, but he added something to it because it had it scratchy, you know, and they needed the scratch in it. I remember when I got my copy, it was all out of one speaker, too. It wasn't even in the middle. It was like on one side of the speaker and all scratchy. And I thought something was wrong until I read the note on the back. Of course, I was a kid.
I remember when I got the record and I played it and my mom heard it, who my mother wasn't a musician, but she heard the record skip and then it go back. And she's like, that was recorded like that? Why would they do that? You know? And then all of a sudden, I thought it was totally awesome.
Oh, yeah. Well, the monkeys, I think they might have had a sense of humor.
Oh, yeah.
Possibly, you know, since they had their own comedy show, they might have had a sense of humor about a few things.
It's good stuff.
Are you looking forward to playing the second game, Michael?
I am indeed, with Mark, whenever he gets here, I guess.
Do you know what was great? I've got to tell you guys. We had Mark, we had Michael, we had myself, and we had Charles Rosenay on text. And we all came to the conclusion the top worst monkey song. And number one, we all got it. Guess which one it was, guys? It's off More of the Monkees. Have a guess. Fred, you have a guess which is the worst monkey song of all times?
Can't figure it out, huh?
Oh, it has to be the Day You Fall in Love.
Yep.
And you know, Ken, how are you? You're looking fine there, man.
We didn't show each other.
The day we fall in love.
We all had the same bad song as number one.
Now, listen, we're looking for the champion. We're looking for the champion. If he doesn't turn up, okay, I don't know where's Ken Michaels, right?
If anybody's the champion, it's Ken Michaels.
Can you do me a favor, Ken? Send him a text and tell him we're waiting for him.
I'll say this. It's a bunch of dudes saying that The Day We Fall in Love is the worst Monkees song. But if you could show me a few chicks who say the same thing, then I'll agree with you. But that might be you might just be not the target audience of the song.
Well, you know, maybe a bunch of 16-year-old girls in 1966, maybe, okay?
Yeah, exactly. I agree. I agree with that.
I think one of the first songs that my brother and I used to play guitar with is I'm Gonna Buy Me a Dog. So that was like, that's pretty cool stuff.
There's only like two chords in it, so it's really easy.
Well, that's why it was one of the first ones we did.
Yeah.
I've only gotten to three chords after that, so.
I've texted him.
Great. I'm wondering where Fred's gone now. Fred's back. I love this. Come in, go out. Fred, come on in.
Be right back. Let me find that.
Welcome back, Fred. Welcome back.
Oh, there he is.
Welcome back.
Yeah, everything's fine.
Hello.
Now, I'm just waiting.
Right, I think we broke up a little bit.
That's all right. I'm just waiting now for Ken, and we're going to start. Ken's coming up now.
Oh, is he on his way? There he is.
Hey, Ken.
Howdy, everyone.
Howdy. Hey, Ken.
Hey.
All right, Michael, hey, show me the book, and we've got to let you go, and you can just wait for the second round.
Sure. So
he's gone. Hang on a minute. Ken's gone.
There we go.
Come back, Ken.
Come back, Ken.
That's the first one.
Yeah, I'll have to check that out.
I love the cover of the first one because it references a mad, mad world.
Oh, it's wonderful. Yeah, the back is even more complicated.
I know. You get all the references in there.
Scott Shaw did it, and he actually helped design some of the Monkees album covers, too, more recently, you know, with Rhino.
Mm-hmm. All right, where can they buy the books?
I'm here.
Anywhere.
Where can they buy the books?
Amazon, Barnes & Noble. It's published by Bear Manor Media. Just do a search for my name, and you'll find it. You know, it's everywhere. Thanks for asking.
Michael, we'll see you in game two. Just hang around, okay? All right, guys. We're lined up. We're ready to go. We're going to start the show. Charlie, I want you to watch, okay? So I'll decide who's won and who hasn't, but if you see any discrepancy, I want you to say it. If I don't hear from you, we'll just move on to the next question. Mr. Lou, Mr. Shampoo, you ready to go?
Yes, Plastic.
All right. Here we go. We're going to go through these questions. Hopefully I haven't asked them before, but if I have, then you should know the answers. So that's to your benefit. All right. Here we go. In 1972, Don McLean sang about American
Pie.
Yeah. That's right, Ken. Well done.
I feel like I'm getting the hang of this.
Did you write down one for Ken there, Mr. Shampoo?
Now, is that Ken W? Is that Ken W? Plastic?
It is.
No. It's Ken Michaels. It's Fred Velez. And it's Ken Womack. Okay? You got that?
Now, do we have to buzz in or anything?
No, you just yell out.
Yell.
Okay. We're good yellers.
You're right. You got to yell it out. All right, here we go. Question two. Elvis Presley's 1969 hit was Edge of.
Can you repeat that?
Yeah, what's the last word of the song? Elvis Presley's 1969 hit was Edge of.
Edge of.
One word, it's Elvis. Easy.
Tomorrow.
Did you say that, Ken?
I said tomorrow. I was just going for it.
Okay, who said that one? I didn't see it.
It was me.
Okay, Ken, wrong answer. Now it's between the two of you. Right? Come on, Ken or Fred, have a go at it.
Don't know.
Edge of what?
Edge of. Not Edge of Destruction. I know that.
If you guys don't know, we're going to pass on that question.
Right, I don't know that
reality.
One.
I'm surprised you guys didn't know it, but do yourself a favor and play that song. Don't you know it? B Because the edge of reality. Come on.
Oh,
come on,
sorry. Charlie.
Don't know. All right. Okay. You got me.
It's got you too. All right, move on. All right. I Started a Joke was recorded by who?
The Bee Gees. Say that again?
Yes, who said Bee Gees?
I did.
Well done,
right,
Fred.
Say your name because I'm just hearing voice. Is that you, Ken W?
No, that was Fred.
It was Fred.
Well done, Fred. Well done, Fred. Well done. What's the score now to make sure Nathan's awake?
Plastic, Fred has one.
The Bee Gees.
And Ken has one.
Okay, great. Well done.
Ken W.
Me.
Okay, great. Now, Simon and Garfunkel had a hit with Bridge Over Troubled.
Water.
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 Yeah, who said it first?
I think I did.
No,
okay,
you
well done, Fred.
That was me, buddy.
All right. I'll give you one.
Who was it?
Ken W.
It was the W.
Ken W. Well done, man. All right.
So we're verbally buzzing. I get it now, Plastic.
You got the buzz.
Jump in there.
Here we go. Match the lead singer.
The stakes are high.
All right. It's very important that we hear the questions, all right? Match the lead singer with the 60s group, Freddie and the
Dreamers.
Dreamers.
Yes. I'll give that to Ken Michaels. Easy. Yep. Right. Lola was recorded by
Kinks.
Kinks.
Yes. Give that to Ken Michaels. He's coming up. He's coming up like a train. Here we go.
In a manner of speaking.
Pamela was the 1967 hit for Wayne.
Chung.
Dreamers.
No, hang on. I got two wrong answers, so I think Fred didn't answer.
I didn't.
That's why you won. Because the answer is Wayne Fontana. Thank you, guys.
Oh, okay. I will
so
by
if you say two wrong answers and it's two people, the third person who didn't answer gets the point.
Ah.
Well, I've got people coming in left, right, and center now, so let's keep moving. This is easy. I Should Have Known Better was a hit song for the
Beatles.
Well done, Fred. You're awake.
You're killing it, Fred.
Right. Summer Holiday was a hit song and movie for Cliff Richard in the Shadows, true or false?
False.
Who said that?
Ken Michael said false.
Well, I need someone else to answer because that's not right.
Well, I'll say true.
Well, I think you just got it, Ken.
Ken,
what's the score now, Nathan, if you're still awake?
Which Ken got it, Plastic?
W.
I think Ken Michael got it. Did you get it?
No, it was W.
Ken W got it.
Oh, sorry, Ken. I'm confused from the two Kens.
Ken W.
All right, Ken W. Did you get that, Nate?
I'm hearing a lot of the audio repeated over and over several times. So,
was that?
Guys, I need to know which Ken it was.
Ken W. got it, Mr. Shampoo.
Thanks for that, Charlie. That's what you're there for.
Patrick, I know, that's why I make the big bucks.
We need you to do that. Okay, here we go.
Hold on. Who was it, Charlie?
Ken W. I'm pointing.
Ken W. Okay. So right, the score is
right there.
So the score is 3 for Fred, 3 for Ken W,
uh-oh,
and 2 for Ken M.
Right. We got 6 questions left.
I got to let you all know something. I'm hearing the audio repeat many times over.
Okay, can I suggest you take the headphones off and see what happens? Ken, can you hear me?
Yes, I can.
Ken, take off the earphones.
Okay.
Take the earphones off if you've got a head problem, like with the earphones.
The same thing's over.
Okay, can you take the earphones off? Is that better?
Talk.
We lost him.
Can you hear me?
I can hear you.
Just
can you hear me, Ken?
Now.
We can't see you, Ken. We'll just wait. What's the score again, Nathan?
Well, Plastic, it's 3 for Fred.
Yeah.
3 for Ken W. And yep. 2 for Ken M.
Okay, 6 questions to go. Remember that.
Okay.
All right. Are you still there, Ken?
It's very important that we don't cheat and we give everyone a fair go. So,
what's the prize? I don't think I remember hearing about that.
There's no prizes. Come and have fun.
Okay, I'm ready to have fun. Prize.
Ken, didn't you offer me one of your books? The prize is for me.
That's you getting the prize.
Thank you. Now Ken's coming back.
Okay, you get a...
Ken, we got your double.
Okay.
We got your double now. I don't know why.
Welcome back, Ken.
Hey.
That's it. Hey, there you go. Okay, let's continue on. 6 questions left. 3 for Fred, 3 for Ken W, and 2 for Ken Michaels. So do you hear me all right, Ken? Put the headphones back on. Do you hear me?
Hello.
Can you hear me?
We lost his voice.
I don't know what he's doing. Ken, can you hear me?
Can you
come out and go back in?
This is going to make
what I love about this live show. Hang on. He's trying to tell me something.
I think he's saying.
Unmute. Are you there now? His microphone is not connected.
Oh, he's got it. He's got it.
Are you back in?
I can
hear. Thank you, man. All right, let's go. 6 questions. All right. Suzi Quatro recorded a song called Devil Gate.
Status Quo.
What?
Status quo.
Not status quo. I said. Okay. Now it's up to Fred and Ken to work it out. No one used Google. Suzi Quatro recorded a song called Devil Gate. One word.
Road.
Which one?
Double Gate Road.
Who said road?
Double Gate Road.
Sorry, Fred, you're wrong.
I did.
You win, Ken. You win. Oh. It's double. It's Devil Gate Drive. Sorry, Fred.
Oh, that's right.
All right.
I just saw her movie too.
That's beautiful. I did too, Suzi Q. I love her. Here we go. Tommy James and the Shondells had a 1968 hit with Moni.
Moni.
Yes, Ken got that.
Nice job, KM. Moni.
Well done. Here we go. Which song wasn't recorded by Jeff Tull? Rocket Man, Sweet Dream, or Living in the Past? Which song wasn't recorded?
By whom?
By Jethro Tull.
Rocket Man.
Who said that?
Rocket Man.
Ken W.
You're completely right.
I think we both
Ken
did.
Ken W. gets a point.
Knock it out.
Right. Match the lead singer with his 70s group. Graham Parker and
The Rumor.
Yeah, who said that? Was it Ken W again, or who was it?
It was Ken W again. Yeah.
What's the score now?
Three.
Plastic. For Ken M, it's 4. For Ken W, it's 4. And for Fred, it's 3.
I think
is that right, guys? I thought Ken W had more.
He does. Don't worry about it.
What are you on? Yeah, I know you got more. All right,
it's
are you
true.
On 5 or 6?
I think Mr. Shampoo has it against me.
No,
I want to lock that right now. And I know Fred can tell too.
What score do you, I love this? What score do you think you had, Ken?
Oh, I leave that to the official scorekeeper.
All right, what score have you got, Nathan, since you're doing the score?
Okay, it's 3 for Fred.
Yep.
4 for Ken W. And
yep.
4 for Ken M.
That sounds okay. good to me. Let's fight to the death. Let's go.
So Ken
Mr. Shampoo, wait, Mr. Shampoo.
He's inherited one, and Ken W. was more, but he's gone down. What's
Mr.
up,
Mr. Shampoo? W? How many points do I have?
You're winner.
Now listen, two questions left. Okay, so what,
is it, babe?
With your eyes. Where are you going, Charlie? I need you to watch now. Two questions left. Ready?
I'm watching.
Right. Okay. Pandora's Box and Conquistador were hits for which group?
Procol Harum.
Yeah, who said that first?
That was Ken W.
Ken W. One question left.
I think that brings you up to 4 points.
I think he's one in front now. Surf City was recorded by
Janet.
Can I say the question again? Because that's not the question. Okay, so the three of you answered that, didn't you?
Yeah, but Fred was there first. He's,
that wasn't the answer. That wasn't the answer. So listen again, right? Now, don't answer this question. Surf City was recorded by Jan or Dean, true or false? So don't answer it because you're wrong. It's actually true. Right now, this is the last question.
Yay.
Who gets that point?
We can only have one winner, and I'm not going to say who I think's going to win it because that wouldn't be fair. All right, so listen to the question. If you say the answer, you're out of it. If You're Going to San Francisco was recorded by
Scott McKenzie.
Yep, he got it right. What's the score now?
Plastic. It is 5 for Ken M, 5 for Ken W, and 3 for Fred.
All right, Fred, you can still win. You just have to win every question.
It's up to you, Fred. It's all about you.
All right, here we go. We're going to keep it moving now. This is the last question. If either Ken or Ken 2 gets it, they're going to be the winner.
This one's the last question. Okay.
This is the last question.
Unless Fred wins. Unless Fred wins, then we play on. Here we go.
I hope Fred wins. I don't want this ever to stop.
All right, can we listen? Thelma Houston had a 1977 hit song with Don't Leave Me.
Now.
Say that again.
Hang on, who said now? Ken W's out. Don't Ken Leave Michaels, Me.
Ken Michaels needs a repeat.
What did you say, Ken? Be honest.
Repeat the question, Plastic.
Yeah, but did you answer something there, Ken? I'm asking you, Ken Michaels.
Say it again.
He didn't. He asked you to repeat the question.
Okay, that's fine.
Everyone's talking over you. Everyone's
not cheating.
Talking over
here
you.
We go. Now it's between Fred and Ken.
Which Ken?
Thelma Houston had a 1977 hit song with Don't Leave Me
This Way.
That's it. He got it. Yeah. Ken Michaels got it. What's the score now? That's it, isn't it?
Plastic. It's 6 for Ken M, 5 for Ken W, and 3 for Fred.
Thank you, guys. The champion remains. We got a winner. Ken
Way
Michael.
To go, Ken Michael.
Thank you, Ken W. Let's sell some books for you. Thank you, Fred, for joining us today. It was fantastic.
Congratulations, Ken Michael.
You're welcome.
Thank you, Ken W.
Everybody's repeating over and over.
I know, I can't help it. I'm not worried about that problem you got there. It's coming from your end. I can't help it.
I can't really hear well.
Say goodbye, Fred.
Goodbye.
Say
goodbye.
Bye, see Fred.
I won.
Ken W., see you soon.
Yes, you did.
Okay.
He's gone. Now you're back again. Now we've got new contestants. How's that? Play some bit of
I won.
Before we go to the next game.
I didn't care.
It's time for a musical break. There's a new
world. The singer.
All the
Australian group.
And I'll be there someday. If you could hold my hand, I'll still meet you there beside me. No matter what I do, I'll never find another you.
Thank you, Charlie. Welcome. Hey. Mark Arnold.
Hello.
Michael A. Ventrilla. Now, I've got to tell you, Ken Michaels, the heavy ammunition is coming now. These guys, they know their stuff.
Hi, Mark. Hi, Michael.
Are you enjoying it, Ken?
Hello.
Hi.
Ken, what's it feel like being champion and still there?
I couldn't hear anything before. I couldn't win.
What about now?
We have an advantage, Mark.
Yes.
We need me now, Ken.
Whatever you're saying is repeating over and over again. So,
well, no, I don't know what Ken talking at the
same time, so I can barely hear anything.
Listen, Ken, turn down your microphone a little bit. Turn down your volume. Might help.
You can't adjust the volume on this microphone. It's already
That's not helping. That's
wait
not
a
help.
Wait a you. Minute.
Unplug.
Plastic, I have a question.
Yeah, go for it, Charlie.
If Ken Michaels hears the question five times and answers it five times, does he get 5 points or one?
You'll get one. But
I actually get less points.
Ken,
still repeating.
Ken, can you hear me?
Right now I did.
Okay. Can you hear me now?
If I unplug the headphones, you can't hear me talk to you.
Okay, got it. All right, let's get into the game. All right, here we go. All right, Nathan Lou, you're going to keep score this time?
I got it, Plastic.
All right, I'm glad you got it. I've got all the confidence in the world in you. Okay, here we go. 15 questions. Everyone's ready. Everybody Loves Somebody was a 1964 hit.
Dean Martin.
That's the one. He's away. Let's go.
I heard you there.
That's great. I'm glad you came to crystal clear. Right. You got a point. Here we go. Freddie and the Dreamers had a 1965 hit with I'm Telling You.
Now.
Right. Michael A. got that. That's right. Well done. You point, Charlie D. Which song was not recorded by Roy Orbison? Right? Poison Ivy, Penny Arcade, or Only the Lonely?
Ken said something. Did you answer it, Ken?
Poison Ivy. Which song wasn't recorded by Roy Orbison?
I said Poison Ivy,
Penny Arcade, or Only the Lonely?
I guess Poison Ivy is not the right answer.
Poison Ivy is the right answer.
Right, but I don't know if Ken Michaels had said he answered first, but I couldn't understand.
I heard was Poison Ivy, so I said Coasters.
All
right, at least you're honest, Ken. We appreciate it on this game where no one cheats.
2 points. You guys have the advantage.
All right, what's the score so far, Nathan Lou?
Who got the point, Plastic?
Michael.
Michael A.
Oops. We'll give it to him.
It's tough, isn't it, Mark?
I don't know what a... Okay, the score is 2 for Michael, 1 for Ken, and then for Mark.
All right, here we go. Let's see if we can get a marker point. All right, here we go. Summer in the City was recorded by which group?
Love is Cool.
All right, who got that?
I said it, but I think everybody
Charlie
said
it. I think everyone said it.
Yeah, everyone.
Oh, Loving Spoonful. How about that? Nobody said
everybody answered, but Michael answered before anybody else.
Okay, give it a Michael A. That's what we need to do. Right. Name the 60s duo. Sonny and
Share.
Yeah, I think that was Mark.
Yes.
Okay, well done, Mark. You're above it.
Good job, Mark.
I got to make at least one point on this.
All right. The letter was a 1967 for the Hawks. Okay.
He said
Ken Michaels got that. Match this lead singer with his 70s group. Elvis Costello and?
The Attractions.
The Attractions.
Yeah, well done, Michael A. What score are we at now?
One of my favorite bands, yes.
Well, Plastic, Michael's at 4, and Ken is at 2, and Mark is at 1.
Oh. Right, here we go. Elvis had a hit song with Crying
in the Chapel.
Well done, Ken Michaels.
I was thinking Elvis Costello.
Elvis Costello, yeah, exactly.
I was saying Crying.
Good job, Ken.
All right, here we go.
Crying, Waiting, and Hoping. I mean, is that... Anyway.
Right, let's keep it moving. Unchained Melody was recorded by which duo?
Righteous Brothers.
Mark had that.
Mark got that. Okay, I'm glad I need you there, Charlie. Well done.
Yeah, talk fast around here.
Sam Cooke had a 1961 hit song with Cupid. True or false?
True.
Couldn't hear
That's
it.
That's right.
I didn't hear who you said did it, but that's okay. Mark got it.
Who said true first?
Mark.
Well done. What's the score?
Well, Charlie was saying Michael, but I want to know who really it was.
So this was it? Mark.
Mark got that last one.
Mark got it. I okay. saw Michael's mouth move, but Mark got it.
Okay, thank you very much.
Plastic?
I'm a ventriloquist.
Mike got 4. Ken has 3. And Mark has 3.
It's the monkeys.
Listen. Play a little bit a chord. Play a chord between the answers there, Charlie.
You got it.
Right. That's what I want. Now, we're talking about the Sgt. Pepper album.
Sgt. Pepper. Okay. Sorry.
Are you listening, Ken Michaels? The Sgt. Pepper album. You should know all about it. When you look at the album, tell me the name of the wax figure of the boxer. Who is it?
Sonny Liston.
Sonny Liston.
Well done, Michael A. Right. What is so significant about the back cover of the album? It's the first time
lyrics were printed on the album for the month.
Well done, Michael A, coming home like a train. That's what I want. Costa, I mean, Charlie, try not to go that high. That's it. Here we go.
Words for us.
Name the song title from the album. When I'm
64.
Well done, Michael A. Again, what's the score?
No, I didn't do that one. That was Mark. That was Mark.
Who was it?
That was Mark.
Okay, I saw your lips move. That's okay. That goes to Mark, Nathan. What's the score?
Plastic, the score for Michael is 6, Ken, 3, and Mark, 4.
Right. We've got 2 questions 64. Left. Okay. 2 questions left. Right. Prior to the Sgt. Pepper album being released, 2 songs became a double A-side single.
Denny Lane and Strawberry Fields Forever. I think Michael got it. Oops. Yeah, Michael got it.
I'll tell you the answer anyway. See, has anybody not answered that question? I think, who has not answered the question?
Ken Michaels did not answer the question from what I saw.
I didn't hear it.
Good. You know what? You just got yourself a point for doing nothing because this is the question.
Oh, no. It was another true false, right?
No,
listen to the question. Prior to the Sgt. Pepper being released, 2 songs became a double A-sided single. Penny Lane was one song. What was the flip side? So the answer was Strawberry Fields. Ken Michaels, you got yourself a point for not listening. What's the score now?
That's how I win.
Classic, the score is 6 for Michael, 4 for Ken, and 4 for Mark.
Say it again. I'm not listening now myself. What is it? Slowly.
That's okay, Classic. It's 6 for Michael, 4 for Ken, and 4 for Mark.
We got the last question. We got the last question, okay? John Lennon got the idea for the song being for the benefit of Mr. Kite from a book or a circus poster?
Circus poster.
I got that as Michael A.
Yeah,
what the score?
Who got the point? Michael?
Yeah.
Hey. Yes. Yeah.
He was a split second faster than me.
We need buzzers.
Michael has 7, Ken has 4, and Mark has 4.
Gentlemen, I want to thank you, Ken Michaels. I salute you. You've done really well. We are proud of you on this show. You've been our longest standing contestant. Take a bow. Tell me more.
Thank you for having me on.
Tell me more about
the home version of our game.
Tell me more about Talk More Talk. What's happening?
Oh. Okay, so.
What's happening with Talk More Talk? What's coming up?
Okay, Talk More Talk.
Okay, Talk More Talk.
Everything
all right.
Is coming in late. It's all being repeated.
Okay. Thank you so much, about... Ken, for playing. Thank you, okay. Ken. Thank you. Mark.
Congratulations,
Mark
Michael.
Arnold. Mark Arnold, thank you for playing. I thought you'd do a little bit. Thank you, Mark. See, Mark.
That's all.
Now all I can say is, Michael A., you're with us. How's that?
Thank you.
Now, who's on? We're waiting for some other contestants to come up shortly. We're ahead of time.
Okay.
Well, I think the four of us should sing an Elvis Costello tune while we're waiting.
Yeah, play whatever.
Actually, Nick Lowe, right? As I walk through this wicked world, searching for light in the darkness of insanity. Come on, sing. I ask myself, is all hope lost? Come on, Michael. See nothing but pain and hatred, misery. But each time I feel like this inside, there's one thing I want to know. What's so funny about peace, love, and understanding? Yeah.
Congratulations, Michael.
Fantastic.
That was in G, right?
It was. Where are you out of, Michael?
I'm out of tune is what I'm out of.
Here.
Oh, well. I thought it'd be fun to play along.
It's well, kind of tough.
So far, 2 games down. Did you enjoy that?
Yep. Oh, I'm way out of tune. Okay, sorry. Anyway. No, I'm –
That was fantastic. Now we're going to wait for game 3. Anybody that's playing game 3, you know who you are. You can come on and we'll play. If not, we'll be doing tunes for another 20 minutes. Tell me now, Michael, have you got plans to write another book?
Not another music book right now, no. There's no real ideas we have at the moment. Part of the key is getting a publisher willing to publish something. So no, there's no music books planned. I got other books coming out, yeah, but they're fiction, you know. They're not nonfiction like this.
What other monkey news you got? Any new monkey news?
No, I'm afraid not. I mean, things are kind of going slow. Mickey is planning on putting out a cover album with Mike's songs.
I knew about that.
Yeah.
Because I did a show and Coco Dolans came on the show, which is great. Did you see that?
No, I didn't. I didn't know that.
Yeah, I got another show that's called Plastic EP, Robin and Rich.
Ah. Oh,
so
well.
Now I'm just waiting for a few contestants. Here we go. Welcome, Jim. Gotcha. I'm just waiting. I love technology today. It's great, isn't it? So hopefully Jim will join us.
He's a spinning circle.
I got to say, my head fits in this circle perfect tonight.
You're a real target.
That's it, exactly. Thank you. Come on, Jim.
Boy, I'm out of tune.
Don't worry. Hopefully he's coming on. I love this game myself personally. It's what you don't expect that makes the show.
What? It'd be great if you could figure out some technological way that you could, we could push a button and have like a buzzer so you can figure out who went first, you know?
Yeah, like, how do we work that one out? Any ideas there, Michael?
I'm not a technical person, computerized. I'm not sure what you could do, you know?
I'm not technical at all. That's why I'm just a head here on the wall. What else is happening, Nathan, with All You Need Is Love?
Well, Plastic, we're just in rehearsals for the Rock Show 2. We're quite excited about, coming on and doing a show for your Plastic Show exclusively for yourself, you know?
I can't wait because it's going to be all Beatle early songs. I can't wait. The set list has been set. The guys sound fantastic every time you're on the net with practice. You sound great.
Thanks very much, Plastic. I want to say hi to all my guys in the band. Van.
Yeah, go for it.
I want to say hi to Van, Reed, Brian, Aaron. If you're watching.
You're coming in crystal clear there, Michael.
Got a good camera. It's not part of the computer. It's I got it separate.
I know. And I can't I can't understand people. I'm just saying in general. You want everything to work proper, but when it doesn't work, what do? I reckon just break out in a song. That's all you can do. Come on, play something, Michael.
I'm afraid to play it. This has been sitting in my closet for a while. I haven't played it in a while, and apparently I can't seem to get it in tune. Every time I tune it, it goes right back out again.
Well, I don't think people care if it's in tune or out of tune. Just play a bit of a song.
Nathan, what do you play? What instrument?
I play bass guitar.
Oh, so do I normally when I'm in a band. I'm the bassist for most of the bands I've been in.
Congratulations, Michael.
I haven't been in a band for so long, though. It's been years when I was in college and then after college for a while. I don't know. Start singing. Well, she was just 17. You knew what I knew. Sing it.
No, the voice sounds all right. Keep singing. Welcome, okay, Jimmy.
Hello.
How are you? Are you coming in clear?
Yeah. Okay. Go on my laptop and it.
You look fantastic. Let me introduce you to the current champion, Michael A. Ventrilla. We're waiting for another player and then we'll get into 15 questions. Tell us a little bit about your podcast, Jim.
It's called Jim and Mike Talk, and mostly music. Talk about TV, movies, but we just started doing interviews recently, like Plastic EP. Not as many as he does. We interviewed Chuck Negron from Three Dog Night. That was like a month ago. So we're almost a year in. We only do it monthly, but we have fun. Me and my friend, Mike. We do it here in New Jersey. That's where I'm from.
That's great. I like the setup that you've got too.
Yeah, my keyboard's back here. And
yeah, also that screen, that TV screen that you got of the show that I saw, that was great.
Oh, yeah. I'm on the other side now.
Fantastic.
Where about in New Jersey?
Washington.
Oh, I'm in the Poconos. I'm in Stroudsburg, not that far away.
Yeah. Yeah, I have a print shop in Clinton, New Jersey.
Okay. Now, I've got to say something to you, Jim. Michael has written two Monkees books.
Oh, great. Very nice.
What? Tell us the names of the books again. Come on, give us a plug.
Looking for the Good Times, Examining the Monkees Songs One by One, talks about every individual song they ever wrote and all the albums. Headquarters is about their solo years, where, you know, after they went off on their own, and goes into detail. It's more of a timeline. We go through it year by year. Here's what they did this year. Here's what they did that year, that kind of thing. So they're two separate books with lots of illustrations and pictures and, you know, lots of information and charts and things. So it's not like it's just boring reading. So I'm real proud of them.
Yeah.
When did they come out?
Good Times came out around 3 years ago, and Headquarters came out about January. So it's not even a year ago. So it's as up to date as it can be given when they were written. Yeah, Good Times came out before that Christmas album they did. So that's not in there.
I've got to ask you, there might be some. Mike's song, You Just Might Be the One. Tell me about that. It's one of my favorite songs, plus The Kind of Girl I Could Love. Can you tell me a bit about those two songs?
Well, those are both Mike songs, obviously. Which one was the first one you mentioned?
You Just Might Be the One.
You Just Might Be the One, yeah. That was back when they were first getting started, in the sense that they first got control of their own music and could do their own songs. And Mike, I don't know what to say about them, you know, other than they're very good songs and they're well recorded, but none of them were really with the Monkees. It was mostly just Mike and backup performers at that point, which is something that was kind of weird, because one of the first Mike songs on the very first album, during the lead, he says, "Oh, pick it, Luther." You know, because you're going, well, here you are complaining that people aren't taking the Monkees seriously as musicians, and you're giving credit to another musician. I always thought that was kind of funny. You know, it's like, shouldn't have said that, Mike.
Yeah, but they edited it out anyway. They tuned that line down.
Yeah. Some versions you don't hear it. Right.
I've heard it. It's great. Now, what about The Kind of Girl I Could Love?
Well, I'm not sure what I could tell you about it. I could look it up in the book. Let's see. I'll go to the index.
More of the Monkees.
More of the Monkees, yep.
It's my favorite song.
No, it's a great song, you know, and it's, let's see, what page is that on? 31. Let's see what I say. But that's, you know, that's what I like about this, being able to find it and remember stuff, because I wrote this years ago. that was written with Roger Atkins, who used to write The Animals' It's My Life, and he wrote some other songs for The Animals, so he wrote it with them. He also wrote a song for Davy Jones' first album before The Monkees. And it's really, it's a short song. It's like a minute and 50 seconds or something like that. You know, it's like it's verse, chorus, verse, and then it sort of ends. It doesn't really repeat the chorus again, which is kind of strange. You could have made it a little bit longer. In the book, I say it could use more cowbell.
Have you got a Monkees question there, Jim, that you want to ask about a Monkees song?
Not really.
Okay.
I like the Monkees. I don't know all the songs, though.
No,
I like Auntie Griselda.
So. That was the best one to play. No, we when I was a kid watching the Monkees, it's like that's what convinced me to learn to play guitar and bass and being, because other kids wanted to grow up and be astronauts, and I wanted to grow up and be a monkey, you know. So that's what got me into music. That's why it was influential to me. Not that I don't think, you know, they're the greatest band in the world, but there wasn't a book about it, and I thought it would be good to do a book about it.
Have you met any of them?
I've met Mickey a couple of times. And that's about it. I saw Peter at a convention, but I didn't really get to say hi to him or anything.
I met Davey and Mickey and Peter, not at the same time.
Yeah.
Autograph show. Do you know about Chiller Theater?
Sure. Yeah. No, the first time I met Mickey, it was at a Beatles convention in New Jersey, one of the best, and he was a guest there. So I went up and talked to him there, and that was very nice. And then the second time was at a concert he did here in Pennsylvania afterwards, and he was signing autographs and things.
So, oh, was that?
It was in Sellersville.
Oh, Sellersville.
Yeah.
Sellersville?
Yeah.
Yeah, I've been there.
And he was very nice both times. I tried to interview him for the books, and he didn't want to do it. So
I had a different experience.
Good or bad? Or
maybe he was having a bad day.
No.
He was there to sign autographs, and he didn't really – I tried to start a conversation with him, and
Well, I
wasn't going anywhere.
The first time I went, I got his autograph at that Beatles convention, and I told him how much he had influenced me to become a musician and be in a band and everything. And he smiled and went, "That's great," and held out his hand and shook my hand. Of course, he had other people coming, so he couldn't really, couldn't really have a long conversation. Yeah. He had to get out of the way.
No, I was going up in the elevator, and he was standing right next to me. You can only fit about, I don't know, 5 or 6 people in there. And I said, "Hey, Mickey, how's it going today?" Won't say anything. Couldn't wait to get off the elevator, and he's at an autograph show. So maybe just having a rough day.
Well, yeah, you know, there are people like us.
Yeah.
You know, they can get stressed about anything.
No, I know.
Mm-hmm. You know, I just want to say, Nathan Lou, what else is coming up for you?
Well, you know, we've been getting a lot of cancellations with the COVID-19, so we're quite disappointed, but we're staying sharp by just practice, as Artie Surf says, you know, and, you know, we want to be a lot better than we were before the COVID-19, so we're working a lot on that right now and, you know, creating a brand new show and,
what's the name of the band? What's the name of the band?
We're from Canada. We're called All You Need Is Love, Tribute to the Fab Four.
Oh, okay. I didn't realize that was the name of the show. I'm sorry. Yeah. I mean,
Alberta, Canada. And let me tell you, I watch your clips when you practice live on the net, and they're great. Seriously, got a great sound.
Okay.
Thanks, Plastic.
Where'd you get your name, Mr. Shampoo?
Well, you know, I didn't want to use the Beatles name, so I wanted to come up with a message to the world, because All You Need Is Love is you can never take it because it's copyrighted, and it's the best best message in the world, and it's never too late for that. So love is all you need.
No, I mean your name too, Mr. Shampoo.
Mr. Shampoo.
Well, I'm also a Vidal Sassoon trained hairstylist, so I'm the only hairstylist McCartney out there. So, you know. Actually, Plastic gave me the name Mr. Shampoo.
Because Nathan Lou, Mr. Shampoo. It's like Kid O'Toole, she's no fool. You got to take advantage when their names rhyme. It's very important, especially in this business. And I like that picture of yourself, Nathan, with a big shampoo bottle on the net over the last 2 days. That was great.
Thanks, Plastic.
We're just waiting for now our player so we can start. So anybody got anything else to say? Because now we've got no music. Now it's just us.
I can talk about the book I edited about the Beatles, if you want me to talk about that.
Please, could you do that? I'd love to hear it.
Yeah, there is – let me see if I can find the background. Oh, this isn't Zoom, so I can't do that. Never mind.
Yeah, all right.
I edited an anthology of short stories, What If the Beatles Were Fill in the Blank. So we have the Beatles as superheroes, the Beatles as Scooby-Doo investigators, the Beatles as aliens, and all these famous science fiction writers went, "That's a great idea," and it's been doing pretty well. Let me go get a copy of it if I can. It's called Across the Universe, it was a lot of fun. You know, as a Beatle fan, I had a lot of fun going through all the different stories. We had hundreds and hundreds of stories submitted, and we could only fit like 20. So, you know, I got to pick all the best. And so that was my latest music related skill. Now, hold on a second.
While he does that, I've got our friend Reed and Gate Capo. Nathan.
Yes, Plastic.
I've got Reed on.
Well, say hi to him for us.
Say hello. He's saying hello to you. All right, what's that the book is in?
I read.
Across the Universe, Tales of Alternate Beatles. You can see that there's John as a wizard, because there's a story where there are a bunch of, like, Dungeons & Dragons adventurers. There's Ringo as a Ghostbuster. There's Paul as a superhero, Mr. Plastic type of character. And there's George as a zombie. So those stories are all in there somewhere. If you're a Beatles fan, you'll like it, because there's a lot of little inside jokes and references that if you're a Beatles fan, you'll get that not everyone would.
Unbelievable. Where can they buy it from?
Well, it's from Fantastic Books, and it is available Amazon, Barnes & Noble, any place you want to go. This one has a cover by Dave Alvarez. Dave Alvarez is a cartoonist who works on Looney Tunes and has his own comic strip and his own webpage, and he's a big, you know, fairly famous cartoonist, so I was really happy that he wanted to do the cover.
That's great. Mm-hmm. So, Jim, when's your next podcast?
This Saturday. It's an interview with a lead singer of a band called Anything Box.
Yep.
They were on. They had an album in 1990 on Epic, and they have about six or seven. It's mostly one guy now, Claude S. Believe it or not, I've known him since 1988. When my band opened for his, and we became friends, and I just reconnected with him like a year or two ago. So that's like a 2-hour podcast. We also do we do a segment before, and usually a segment after. Do the top 10 from September 19th, 1985. We talk a little bit about each song that was on the top 10. And then the last segment is an interview with Justin Schuyler, who is, he lives in Pennsylvania, and he just put out his first album. He's pretty young. I think he's like 19 or 20. But we did a short interview with him. So, but we just did one with the Gripweeds.
Yeah, that's Kurt right.
Kurt Ryle and Rick Ryle. And I've known them a while. That rhymes.
Yeah, see, exactly. That's what I was going to say. That's what I'm talking about.
But I know them through the Smithereens.
Okay, great.
Michael, you probably heard of the Smithereens.
Absolutely.
I've been friends with them a long time. So you get to meet, you know, through one band, you get to meet another band, you know. And
I
love the group. And they're working on a new album. Actually, what we talked about is an album coming out October 9th. John Lennon, what would have been his 80th birthday. And it's Gem Records celebrates John Lennon. And the Gripweeds have two songs on there. You Can't Do That and Strawberry Fields. And there's other,
the Weaklings are on there.
The Weaklings are on there too.
I like
that. You probably heard of the Weaklings.
Absolutely.
Yeah, I have.
I've heard the Gripweeds. They're great.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Yeah. Yeah, I've known Kurt a while. I mean, and when the lead singer from the Smithereens passed away, I went to like 3 tribute concerts, and Gripweeds played at a couple of them, and I got to hang out with Kurt and talk to him. Cool. So, but I knew Pat and Jimmy.
The Weaklings, have they played at like some of the Beatlefest? I think that's where
I think so.
Yeah, I think that's where I saw them. Yeah.
They're doing a show in Red Bank. I don't know when it is.
Yeah, I'm on their Facebook list, but I don't go to concerts right now until the virus is over.
Oh, yeah, yeah. I had one plan, which was just canceled, which was Ace Frehley. I'm very eclectic with music, so. But that was in Atlantic City. My wife really didn't want to go. It was next month, so I just got the email the other day saying it was canceled. So, so maybe not till next year.
I've heard from our third competitor, he's coming on, so it won't be long, and then we'll be getting into the game. Let's hear that horn one more time there, Nathan. Fantastic.
All together.
That's good for when you're driving along in your car. Baby, you can drive my car.
Well, there's a horn like that on All Together now, right? On the album, yeah.
Did you play the theme today, Plastic? Did you play the Did you play the Brain Teasers theme today, Plastic?
Yes, I did. Yeah, what I'll do is
you must have
missed it. I'm glad you said that. So let's play it one more time, right? Watch this for everybody.
Hi everyone. Thanks for tuning in to Plastic EP's Brain Teasers. I'm Ashton Elizabeth. Are you ready to play the greatest quiz show with Plastic EP and Nathan Lou, Mr. Shampoo? Get ready, groovers. Let's go with the show.
Come on, do you know we're headed for love? Okay, that was great. Our guest is here. Welcome, Mick Lawless. How are you, Mick? Can you hear us? Can you hear me?
I can't hear Mick.
Can't hear you, Mick.
You might have to turn the phone on the side, Mick. Can you hear me?
Technology.
Hang on. I love this. It's great. Let's see. Can you hear me, Mick? It's your audio. Let's see. You're on mute. Here, guys, it's going to come back in. I love this stream, yeah. It's just the best, isn't it? Especially when you're playing a show. Happens to Zoom, happens here. I love it. I think I need to get myself a cane and start tap dancing while I'm waiting for the guest to come on. We won't play the theme song again. We won't.
I had my laptop set up all nice outside, get ready to go, and it couldn't handle, I guess the processor couldn't handle when I went in here.
Yeah, I reckon it couldn't handle me.
And it stopped, you know.
Jim, I reckon it couldn't handle the Plasticky Brain Teaser show.
No. It couldn't handle the floating head and the graphics.
Yeah, exactly. Now we're talking.
That's too much.
Exactly. Now, while we're waiting for that, let's go, hey, Bananas, we think you're groovy. He's coming back now. Hang on.
Ooh.
Hey, Mika, you're back.
Can you guys hear me now?
Oh,
yeah, man, you're perfect. Don't touch anything. Each other?
Yes, we can hear you.
Yeah.
Okay, sorry about that. It's been a long day here in the Boston area for me. It's a work day. It's a work day for me. So
it's
how's
okay.
Everybody doing?
Good, man.
Hi, guys.
Hey, Mick.
Now, I just want to introduce you to everybody. Mick, you know Nathan Lou, Mr. Shampoo?
Hello, Mr. Shampoo.
That's him now. Michael A. Ventrilla, he's written two monkeys books. Show us the monkeys books.
Yeah, of which I don't have the brand new one. I have the other one. Very good. Good read.
Yes, this one, the new one, it's only been out less than a year.
Yeah, I got to get it. I want to get it.
Excellent. Thank you.
Get it direct from Michael so that the profit doesn't go anywhere else.
No.
You agree, Michael?
It's all good.
One here or there, it doesn't really make a difference. Don't worry.
All right, listen. I'll introduce you to Jim Thatcher. He runs a podcast.
Hello, Jim.
Hi. Hi, Mick.
That's great. Now, we're going to start the game, guys. 15 questions. It's very important that you listen to the question in case it's a true or false question, in case it's a member of the band, whatever. Now, what you do is you call out the answer. We'll hear you, and we'll adjudicate the points. So 15 questions, 15 points. Now, if somebody answers a question and they're wrong, and the second person answers the question and they're wrong, the point goes to the person who didn't answer, just so you know.
So we just belt it right out?
That's it. Belt it out. You'll be fine. Just
or
pretend
don't answer and hope
shop.
To get points.
Yeah, the hey, problem we had last
just
time.
Just pretend you're at your shop and you got a normal day going.
Sometimes we were so fast at trying to answer the question before he finished it, we answered a question he hadn't asked, and then we got disqualified. So that's a trick.
Perfect.
All right, guys.
The key is not to answer.
We're going to start the game now. 15 questions, all right? And I'll be watching to see who answers. And if anybody sees who answers first, you can help me out and tell me who it was, all right? No Google, no looking at your phone. Is everybody ready?
Ready, yep. Old.
Yes.
All right, here we go. Gloria was a 1966 hit for which group?
Them.
Now that's Michael and Mick at the same time. That's a point each.
All right.
I'll do that. That's fine.
That's fair.
Okay, agreed.
Okay. Elton John had a hit with Candle in the
Wind.
Yes, that goes to Jim Thatcher. Right, the Mamas and the Papas recorded a song, I Saw Her Again.
Today.
No, you're out. I Saw Her Again.
Last night.
Yes, well done, Mick. And you didn't have to look at one of your albums that you sell there.
No records in sight.
See, well done. Okay. The Tokens had a hit with The Lion Sleeps.
Tonight.
Yeah, Jim got that.
Jim got it?
I think Jim got it.
I thought
Jim got it. Dory, Jim's me at the moment. What's the score?
Plastic, the score is 2 for Jim, 2 for Mick, and 1 for Michael.
Okay. Cat Stevens did not record a song called I Love My Dog, True or False?
False.
Yeah, who said it first? Jim.
Yes.
Well done, Jim. That's the answer. Right, get into it now. These are questions that you guys know. Love Child was a 1968 hit for which female group?
Diana Ross and the Supremes.
Yep, give it to him.
Beat me to that.
Right. Crispy and St. Peter's recorded The Pied
Piper.
Yeah, who said that? Well done, Jim.
Never heard. That was a good guess.
Yeah, exactly.
Right. Where is the Cavern Club?
Liverpool.
Yeah. You
want more specific than that?
No, that's fine. Liverpool, England. Yeah, well done, Michael A. Right. Come Back Again was a 1971 hit for which Australian group?
Ooh.
I'll tell you the first word. Two words. It's a group. Daddy.
Daddy Dewdrop?
No. Any of you other two know? Okay. Forget that question so you don't lose anything, Mick, because no one can answer it. It was Daddy Cool.
Sorry.
Sorry, get ready again. Chapel of Love was a 1965 hit for the Dixie.
Cops.
I think that's Mick and Michael at the same time. Give them a point each and tell us where we're at.
Well, Plastic, Jim is at 4, and Michael's at 3, and Mick is at 3.
Okay, the good thing is, because I had a question there, no one could answer it, I re-ask a question. So one question gets added on. So now instead of being 5 questions, it's another 6 to go. So you're all in there, believe me. Right. Easy. Money, Money, and Dancing Queen became hits for which group?
ABBA.
You know what? I think the 3 of them got it.
My wife loves ABBA, so.
Can you give him a point each day, Nathan, if he's keeping
in? Endure all the songs.
And right. As a side note, ABBA records are selling in my shop like crazy right now, as a side note.
Yeah.
Right, next question. Louie Louie was a 1963 hit for the King's
Men.
Yes.
Okay, I've got to give that to Mick.
Yeah. I was waiting to see if there was more. Okay.
Right. All Shook Up was a 1957 hit for which artist?
Elvis Presley.
Well done, Michael. Elvis Costello. Lucky you didn't say Elvis Costello, because then you'd be out.
Yeah, I started to.
What's the score now, Nathan? Can you tell everyone?
Sure I can, Plastic. Jim is at 5, and Michael's at 5, and Mick is at 5. It's a tie.
Wow.
Wow, this is a fantastic game, guys, because now we got 3 questions left. So we're more than fair to this point, aren't we? Right. Happy Birthday, Sweet 16 was a 1961 hit for who? I'll give you the first name. Neil?
Sedaka.
Yep, Michael A.
It sounds like one of his songs.
Yeah. It does.
Right, match the singer with the 70s group. Paul McCartney and?
Wings.
Michael A got that.
We all know that one. That was just who's faster.
Right, here's the last question. All right, You can still win, Mick and Jim, if you keep answering every question. The Small Faces recorded a song called Lazy
Sunday Afternoon.
I think everyone got that, if I'm right. Am I right?
No, I didn't answer.
I answered. Right. Lazy Sunday
Afternoon. Give it to me and give it to Michael. Thanks, Jim. Right. What's the score?
Did Jim get a point there, Plastic?
No. I didn't answer that last one.
Okay, so the score, right. The score is 8 for Michael, 5 for Jim, and 5 for Mick.
No, I just got the last one. Was that 6, right?
Yeah, he got 6.
Mm-hmm. 6. Yeah. Sorry there, Mick.
We sort of got that last one, but I think Mick was first.
So
sorry, what, Michael?
It's 8 for Michael, 8 for Michael, 6 for Mick, and 5 for Jim.
Okay. In the last question, I'm just saying, Michael A, you both answered together at the same time.
Mm-hmm.
Right. Okay. Well, I've done all the questions. So our winner is Michael A. Ventrilla. Now, right. I want to say, Mick, tell me what's happening at the shop. Tell me what's happening at the shop and where they can come to buy stuff.
Okay, so as you know me from the Loose Salute Michael Nesmith tribute, we're outside of the Worcester, Massachusetts, USA area. I've got a great little old school record store called the Nevermind Shop, and it's full of memorabilia from the 50s through the current, and we're just selling a lot of vinyl right now. Vinyl is king, so excellent. It's all good.
And also, you got a new CD. Tell me about your new CD.
Yeah, actually, I got a picture. We can step out of the frame and where it is. It's called the Happy Nez Year Broadcast.
Chock, yeah, hold it up to the computer. Songs.
What's that?
Mick, can you hold it up to the picture, the computer? Higher, yes. And bring it in. Yeah, like there that. Higher.
That's yeah, the happy. That. The Happy Nez Year Broadcast, an unplugged performance by the four of us, and it was a cybercast to the world in New Year's Day 2019. Professionally recorded, sounds really good. All Nez songs, all 12 Michael Nesmith songs.
Well, Mick, I want to thank you for being on the show. What did you think of it?
I had a good time. I'll come back anytime. It's always a pleasure to be with you, my friend, and all you guys, Michael and Jim and Nathan, it's been nice hanging with you.
Nice seeing you guys.
All right. Peace, guys. Over and out.
Mick, thanks again. Now, bye, Jim, Plastic. Go through your podcast one more time.
Yeah, it's Jim and Mike Talk, and we're on iTunes, Spotify, anywhere, YouTube. We have a little bit of the video from the interview on YouTube. We're mostly audio, so. Thank you.
Fantastic.
Thank you, guys.
Thank you, Nick, for being with us today. Michael,
Plastic, see you.
Bye-bye.
Thanks again. Bye. Well, there you go. Now we're waiting for the new contestants, and we're up to game 4. And, Michael, you're still hanging in there.
Yeah.
How do you feel?
Lucky. Because a lot of these questions, everyone knows I was just quicker. You know, it doesn't mean that was smarter. I was just quicker. Sometimes that's how it works, I guess.
But do you see the main thing is you also have to listen?
Hmm?
I said, congratulations, you did a great job. You're the champ.
Yeah.
And you also have to listen, right, which is the most important ingredient. So while we're waiting, guys, we're going to play for you. Watch this. As soon as I get it up, I love this technology. It's the best, isn't it? Everything works. Here we go. Hey, Bananas, we think you're groovy while we're waiting for our contestants.
Hey, Bananas, we think you're groovy.
We think you're groovy.
Hey, Bananas, we watch a movie.
Watch a movie, yeah.
Drive your June buggies everywhere. Just going crazy without a care. Hey, Bananas, we think you're groovy. Hey, Bananas, we think you're groovy. Love to watch you cause your favorite show.
Hey, Bananas, we think you're groovy.
Hey, Bananas.
Hey, Bananas, we think you're groovy.
Okay, hey, Bananas, we think you're groovy. Now, let me tell you, What a game so far, Nathan. What do you think of the three games we just had?
Oh, they were very, very close, and they were exciting. Michael, you're very sharp.
Let me tell you, with this game now, because it's sped up, what we've got to do now is with our contestants, it's very hard to tell them how long the games go for, but the way it's going, it's like 15 minutes and wait 10 minutes for someone to come. So what we've got to tell them to do is watch the show in case we're running faster so that can come straight on and we don't have this downtime.
Maybe edit it later, you know, or something.
No. There's no editing with this, Michael. We do it live here. We find something to do. Like now, as I said, we've done our intro to the show two times, a fantastic intro. What do you think, Nathan?
I love it. I love the new theme songs for every one of your shows. Robin and Rich, you know, that's a great show. I just love watching it. It's got great appeal. Congrats.
Thank you for that. And also, as I said, this one, Plastic EP's trivia is unbelievable. I love it. So now we're waiting for our competitors. And guess what? They're coming in from South Australia. In Australia, and they wrote a book, Michael, which I don't know if you've seen it. They're the authors of this book, which is great because of the way I've got it. You see that?
It's One called Dream Age.
One Dream Ago. Can you see that?
All right.
Now, the picture of the kangaroo's got the Beatles in the pouch. And guess who did the cover?
I can't even tell, you know, because you've got the background. It's hard to read, as you know.
And I can't help it. That's how it is. Right? But let me tell you.
I know who did the cover.
Who did the cover?
I did.
No.
No, it's Klaus Voormann.
Klaus Voormann did the cover. And Mike Penn,
sure.
Mike Penn did the forward. I love this. The way things are now. Look at that. Watch. With a book, I can disappear. Watch.
Michael Penn, the musician who did, something in blue in black jeans?
No. Mike Penn did the forward.
Okay, sorry.
It's all right. Don't worry. That's why we're here, to get everything right. Aren't we, Nathan?
Yeah. Michael Penn is I don't know if you know his music. He's I know him mostly because he's married to Amy Mann, who I went to school with. So that's, well, I know him.
Cool.
You know, Amy Mann?
What have you got planned for this week, Michael?
Just work. Nothing major. I need to get some more writing done, but you know, somehow in this world right now with all its negatives, it's hard to get in the mood to do anything creative, I'm afraid. It's very depressing lately.
Is it?
Yeah. Of course, I'm also in America, you know, so we have, you know, Trump for president. So that makes you depressing just waking up and finding that out.
And as I said, apart from politics, what else is happening where you are?
The problem is everything is kind of slow because of the virus. And, you know, and America is doing a really terrible job at trying to deal with it. So much stuff is closed. I'm a lawyer and we're doing like court cases like this with video. So we don't have to go into court whenever we can, but sometimes you have to. It's been a very, very weird experience this year. Let me tell you. So.
Crazy.
Yeah. Yeah. We were talking about doing a sequel to this, to the Beatles book. But it didn't sell as well as we had hoped, which surprised me. I guess there's not a lot of crossover between science fiction fans and Beatles fans or something. So that's kind of on hold too. Yeah.
Nathan Lou, I'm sure he's coming back. He's disappeared for a minute, but he'll be back. And isn't it great with Mark Arnold? He's written a few books there, hasn't he?
Oh, he's got quite a few books. Yeah, and that's, I contacted him. He had written a book on the Beatles where he went through every single Beatles song. And I said, we should do that for the Monkees. And he went, yeah, good idea. And we decided it'd be more fun to do it together because then he could give his opinion of a song and I could give my opinion of a song and we could argue about it. I thought it makes it a little better, a little more interesting to read that way, you know, than just a standard one person's opinion.
I like his Chipmunks book. It's a ripper.
Mm-hmm. So, no, I don't have a lot of his books, but I do have the, you know, I have the Beatle one, And he does a lot about animation, and I used to do a magazine about animation as well, but I haven't written any books about that. Actually, we're talking about doing a book of interviews with different animators, so that's another project that's on the back burner that might come about. You know how it is. I got lots of projects. Sometimes they work, sometimes they don't.
Now, also got to say, remember Lennon, Imagine 80? I want everyone to go check out the virtual concert they're going to have on John Lennon's birthday, 9th of October. Mm-hmm. Check it out. The tickets are very reasonable, and it's going to be a great concert. One of the best John Lennon impersonators. So that's coming up. Make sure. Remember Lennon, Imagine 80. Charles Rosenay's organized all that. So we want everyone to check that out while you're waiting.
Yeah, Charles is a good guy. He, I'd known him for years online, and I finally got to meet him last, I guess, in the spring when he had that Peter Tork tribute in Connecticut. Because that's where Peter's from, and his family was there and everything. So there was like a Peter Tork concert convention, one day convention type of thing. It was actually fun to go to. So.
He does some great things. He does some horror things too, you know. Mm. And now he's currently doing drive-in movies. The tickets sell out quick.
Yeah.
You rock up in your car.
And you're safe. And
you watch movies. Yeah. Hmm. In the 60s, it used to be how many people you can fit in the boot of the car.
Right. Because you pay by the car instead of by the person, right. I remember going to some of those back when I was a kid.
Now, Nathan Lou, Charles said you might have gone to the loo.
How did he guess?
Hang on. Olivia, welcome.
Hi, how you going?
Can I just ask you, Olivia, that's your mobog that you got, yeah?
Yes, it is.
Would you be kind enough to turn it on its side?
Yeah.
Long ways and we'll see the whole picture. That's it. Let's give it a whirl. See what happens. There you go. We got full picture now.
Beautiful. Give me a sec.
No worries. We'll just put that out. We'll wait for Dad.
He should be all good. He's just in the other room.
That's fine. Now, as I said, Olivia helped write the book, One Dream Ago,
mm-hmm.
and it's a world-class book. And didn't that surprise you, Michael, that the cover was done by Klaus?
Yeah. Well, what is the book about, though? You didn't tell me that.
It's about in South Australia when the Beatles went there. You can give us a description of the book, Olivia.
Yep, so it's done in three stages. They're all about the Beatles' connections with South Australia. So one stage is the 60s when they came to Adelaide, where they had their biggest crowd ever, and then 300,000 people. The second stage is the Grand Prix days. So we used to have the big motor race here when George Harrison would come to South Australia in the 80s and 90s. And then the third stage is, I'd say today, but it was written 10 years ago now, so the 2000 stage of connections with the Beatles.
Yeah. Wasn't it that when the Beatles first came there, they had a different drummer because Ringo was sick? Is that right?
Yeah. So they had a drummer called Jimmy Nicol. Yeah. So he came in as a replacement because Ringo, I think he had tonsillitis or something.
Yeah.
Welcome to the show,
Jimmy Nicol. Just so you know.
Pardon?
We're looking for Jimmy Nicol. We've put it out on every show. Jimmy, if you're watching, we'd like to do an interview with you. Come out, the Beatle community will embrace you. And we've got people who want to write a book. We've got authors that want to write a book about your story, and you've got a story to tell. So everyone give a wave to Jimmy Nicol. Let's hope you're watching the show. And if you feel like coming on to the show and answering a few music questions, I invite you. No matter where you are in the world, how great's that? Here he is. The famous Michael X. Savers. Hello, Michael. Oh, no, you're back, Charlie.
Because I don't look like here? My dad.
No, that's not your dad, Olivia. Now, listen, tell us what's happening, Charlie.
We were supposed to go to the kids' soccer game, but this is Florida and it's raining, so I'm back.
Well, that's good. Can you play a bit of a Beatles song on the guitar while we can?
Sure. This will be our Olivia, last how game. Are you?
Hello, yeah. How are you?
Olivia, that's Charlie DeCosta. Can you tell me what early Beatles song would you like played, Olivia?
Oh, that's a big question.
Yeah, what you got?
How early?
Early as you want. Please Please Me album. Do you want to hear Please Please Me? Do you want
Please,
to hear?
Please Please Me is a good option.
You wanted that. You want. You don't want that one. You wanted something else. You
no, asked I haven't thought of anything. Want. It's only it's 6:30 where I am. I wasn't thinking too much.
Is the famous Michael X. Savas, who also wrote the book One Dream Ago. How are you, Michael?
Not too bad. How are you, Plastic? Good morning.
Good. We're going to introduce it to everybody here. We got Michael A. Ventrilla. He's written two monkey books. We got Mr. Shampoo, Nathan Liu. We got Charlie DeCosta. And we've got your daughter, Olivia. And what's the song you would like played, Olivia?
Well, I said Please Please Me, but
let's do that one.
If he loved that idea.
Oh, I'm out of tune. Last night I said these words to
everyone sing.
Come on, everybody sing.
Yeah, come
I
on.
I know you never even tried, girl. Come on. Please, please, we all love like I do. Please.
You don't need me to show the way, love.
No, we only do one verse and then we're out. It's done.
Okay, listen. You guys are all ready for the fourth game. It's riveting. I take it you're all ready to play?
Absolutely.
Are you ready, Michael?
Yes.
Yeah.
Are you ready, Olivia?
Yes.
Are you ready, Michael X. Savas?
I am absolutely ready.
What's the X stand for?
Excellent.
Sorry? Excellent.
Yeah.
Okay, groovy. I like your shades. All right. Let's go. 15 questions. Michael is a champion. Will we have a new champion from Australia?
No pressure.
I'm Rev. Now make sure you yell at the answer so we can hear you here because we're tone deaf down this end of the world. All right, give me the intro of the guitar for the show. All right, here we go. Concentrate and listen. Reach Out, I'll Be There was a 1966 hit. For the four
tops.
That's it. Help was a 1965 hit for the
Beatles.
Beatles.
All right, Michael got that. Michael X got that. Right. Which song wasn't recorded by the Rolling Stone? Which song wasn't recorded? Ruby Tuesday. Do It Again. Or Lady Jane?
Do It Again.
Again.
Yeah, Michael A. Michael A got that. Right. The Drifters recorded a song called Under the
Boardwalk.
Michael A got that.
Gotta be fast.
Well, here's a good one. It's Australian. It's an Australian question.
Oh yeah, right. Okay.
No, it's in the book. I didn't make it up. Right. Evie's Part 1, 2, and 3 was a hit for Stevie.
Right.
Yep. Give it a Michael X. I love it. Runaway was a 1961 hit for who?
Del Shannon.
Yeah, you got that. Ray Charles recorded a song titled Hit the Road.
Jack.
I'll be honest with you. It's Michael A. Is that right, Charlie?
Yes, it is.
Okay.
But it was close.
Come on, Nathan Liu.
Well, Plastic, Michael is in the lead at 6. Olivia and Michael have some delicious donuts, and Jim has a donut as well.
Michael X has got a point.
Michael X should have one, yeah.
Good point, yeah.
That's right. I'm sorry.
You're looking at Plastic.
I was just testing you, Plastic.
Now, Olivia, be honest. Did you get a point?
I don't think so.
Okay.
I think let's I got a few fair. Almost points.
What did you say the score was again?
The score is 6 for Michael, 0 for Jim, and 1 for Michael and Olivia.
Hang on, who's Jim?
Yeah, Jim's not playing.
Jim's not playing.
Sorry. Too many games today, you know. Too many games today.
So Michael,
we got Michael X, we got Michael X, and we got Olivia. Just so I straighten you out.
Yeah.
Okay. Michael X has 1, Olivia has none, and Michael has 6.
All right, to make it fair, because
Jim definitely has none.
All right, listen, to make it fair, and at this stage it won't matter, give Olivia 1 point for turning up. Okay, give her a point.
Okay.
Thank you.
You can have some of my donut.
I'm running the show, so it's all right. All right, here we go.
Is this thing on?
Traveling Man was recorded by who?
Plastic EP.
No. Michael, you should have waited. I'm going to give a clue. You're out of this one. That's between you two, Olivia and Michael A. It was recorded by Ricky. Give me a surname. Ricky who? Recorded Traveling Man. He was on a TV show.
Oh, Ricky. Oh, gosh. What is his last name? I know who you're talking about. He did Garden.
Yes, Garden Party was another hit by him.
Right. And I can't think of his last name. I'm going to
think. Come on, we have to go. Ricky somebody.
I would have
starts with N.
I'm a traveling man.
All right, let it go. I'm letting that question go. It's Nelson.
Thank Ricky you. Nelson. I couldn't think of it.
Hello, Mary Lou. How are you? Do you remember that song? Hello, Mary Lou. Come on, Charlie. Have a bit of
goodbye, heart, sweet Mary Lou. I'm so in love with you. I knew Mary Lou. Uh-oh. It never parts. So hello, Mary Lou. Goodbye, heart.
Well done. Well done, Charlie. We love that. Now listen.
Oh yeah.
Name this singer from the 60s. I need the surname. First name is Trini.
Lopez.
That's it.
How many Trinis are there? I mean,
he passed away recently too, unfortunately. Now.
That killed the party.
Beach Boys hits. I need the name of the song, right? So listen. Beach Boys hits were Fun, Fun, Fun and Help Me.
Rhonda.
Yes, well done. Michael X coming home. What's the score now, Nathan?
Well, first I was confused because I didn't know that Michael was competing against his daughter. So hope you guys can get along later. But the score is Michael is at 7. And Michael X is at 2. And Olivia is at 1.
All right. Well, we've got another 6 questions left now. Okay. 6 to go. So it doesn't mean that you can't win Michael X or Olivia, right? As long as you keep winning questions, you're still in there. Okay? Because then if we get a tie, we do another question. All right, here we go.
Who's this? Yeah.
These are so easy, these questions. Buddy Holly sang a song called Peggy.
Sue.
Now, being honest, Charlie. I give that to Michael A and Michael X together.
I'll go with that. I'll concur.
Yes, boys. Give them a point each.
Give,
right, this is good. India
give
Lake,
Mr. Shampoo 2 points.
All right, we've got to listen now. India Thanks, Lake Charlie. Was recorded.
What?
I'll start again. Indian Lake was recorded by what group?
Cow Sills.
You got it. The Supremes recorded a song called You Can't Hurry.
Love.
I'll give that to Michael X, yeah. Where are we at, Mr. Shampoo, if your additions are right?
Well, Plastic, Michael A is at 9, and Michael X is at 4, and Olivia's at 1.
For showing up.
Okay, doesn't matter. It's all about having fun, 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 In the sun, sun, sun. Okay.
Too young. She doesn't know these songs.
Here we go. Bob Seger had a 1969 giant hit with Old Time
Rock and Roll.
Yes, Michael X is coming home strong.
You said 1969?
I said 79.
Okay.
All right. Here we go. Don't rush the answer of this question, okay? Very important. Hey Joe, was it for Jimi Hendrix and the
Experience?
Yes. All right, last question. Match this lead singer with her group. Gladys Knight and the
And the Pips.
I'm going to give that to Michael. That's Michael X. And the end score is, that's it.
Plastic, the score is 10 for Michael A, 6 for Michael X, and 1 for Olivia.
All I want to say is, guys, thank you so much. Michael X Savis, I've got to ask you, tell everybody where they can buy your book, your world-class book. One Dream Ago, tell them where they can buy it from.
Well, they can. There's a Facebook page, but they can email me at msavis, I should spell it with my Australian accent, S-A for Ant, V for Victor, A for Ant, S for Sam, msavis@hotmail.com. Thanks. Thanks, Plastic, for the plug.
That's fantastic. Now, what I want to say is, thank you, Michael and Olivia, for being on. As I said, you guys should be so proud of your world-famous book. It's getting out there. People are knowing about it. I'm telling everybody. I'll tell you after, Nathan Lou.
Thank you. Thanks,
it's been fun tonight. Today. Do you agree, everybody?
Yeah, lots of fun. Thanks for having
guys.
Us, Plastic.
All right, let's until everybody... next week, Michael Trilla, we'll organise the time. We'll organise your contestants. We'll be back again. Everybody wave goodbye now. Plastic EP's Brain Teasers is over for another week, another thrilling adventure. And guess what? We've gone 2 hours, another marathon. Thanks again, everybody. See you soon.